coming from my sister, Amethyst Wells, Emily Wells, and myself, and the entire family. When our mother died, I remember, and our sister, Beth came to Sadler's to visit each and every one of us. She spoke to us and she gave us encouraging words. So, I know it's not easy to lose a mother, but the good Lord will continue to bless and keep our soul. In God we put our trust. Thank you.
And know what I saw. peanut butter going to you. Oh, Lord, help me.
Better some children something to me. Why be all the best? And comforting words the Lord gives and takes. Are you to come big woman and big man? So she not identify you a bed. Well, I haven't seen this little song. May that song would have been going to. Sometimes I feel so lonely. And sometimes I feel so sad. Sometimes life seems so empty. And everything makes me mad. Admit
I don't know who learned it from who, whether mommy learned it from her or she learned it from auntie, but nonetheless, soap was the thing on Saturday. And going up around Auntie Beth, I was always amazed but never said anything of her ability to think, her sharpness. Sometimes you think that you have her in a corner and she finds some way to bring it back around on you, and you wonder. And so my hope is two things I'll leave right with. My hope is that my niece and my daughter and my little cousins who are in school, that they acquire that sharpness. And finally, for all of us, in the words of my mother, her sister, that may all who come behind us find us faithful. Thank you.
Not a thing. She had open arms. Whenever I'd go to her house, she'd say, "I can't feed you, but you can feed my husband because I'm too fussy. Josephine, I can't feed you." But she was always welcoming, no matter what time we went, no matter when I rang her. I remember when I first came, I was like digging out coconut. And I dug out the coconut and I cut my hand, and I thought, and she says, "You should use a blunt knife." She was always giving advice in the correct way, very positive. And to my family, I'd like to say condolences from the Richardson family in England and the Claxton family in England and here also. Her sense of humor, I can see in her family, that will not be lost. She was a smart lady, and that will not be lost either. So again, condolences to everybody. May you rest in eternal peace. You will be missed. One love.
Thank you.
have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. In this time when we feel such heartache, pain, and loss, Scripture offers us so much comfort, encouragement, and victory. It seems that in writing to the Thessalonian believers, Paul knew of some church members who recently lost a loved one. To those who are hurting and grieving, he offers reasons to hope. Paul specifically addresses those in the church who have lost friends, family, or loved ones. He tells them that we should react differently than those who have no hope. Two things we keep in mind: our mourning in natural and our rejoicing in the supernatural.
Pleasant good afternoon to each and everyone. We're here to celebrate the life of a mighty woman of God. She is our healer, touched by his wounded hands ministry healer. And we're here to celebrate her ongoing service today. She has done a job that I believe the Lord has placed her here on earth. She has spent some time with us, but will always be remembered the things that Elizabeth Francis has taught us. At this time, we will sing that song. The congregation will sing the song, How Great Thou Art.
Oh,
great thou art. Remain standing at this time. The evangelist is going to lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, most glorious God, we give you thanks. We give you all the honor and the glory that is due unto your name. Mighty God, we come into your presence, O God, with thanksgiving, O God, and we reverence your throne, mighty God, as we come together today, mighty God, in remembrance of our mother, of a sister, of a grandparent, of a friend. We say thank you, O God, for the life of Minister Elizabeth Francis, mighty God. Father, we are thanking you because, God, she has done the work here on earth, O God. She has impacted many lives, mighty God. And to whom much is given, God, much has been required, O God. And you who have given to us have taken away, mighty God, for your glorious kingdom. And we want to thank you, mighty God, as we come into this presence to remember and give thanks, mighty God. Father, O God, though weeping may endure for a night, joy comes in the morning. And we bless your name that we will be joyous, O God, knowing, O God, that she's wrapped in the kingdom of your arms, mighty God. We are saying thank you, and we call it done. In Jesus' name, amen.
You may be seated. Just before we go into the scripture reading, I'd just like to recognize, according to the program, we have remarks from the Right Honorable Dr. Denzel Douglas, the leader of Her Majesty Opposition, and also representative of this area. I'd also like to recognize Bishop Panner, Pastor Panner, and Pastor Peter Paul and his wife, and any other like to recognize, even the pastor, minister of this local church, Pastor Courtney Mills. God bless you, and all any other ministers that are here to come to share with us this afternoon in this great service for Sister Elizabeth and Minister Elizabeth, a mighty woman of God. At this time, evangelists will take it from here to forth.
At this time, we'll call for the scripture reading, Ecclesiastes 3, 1 to 10, by Ronnie Francis, a grandniece. International and Holy City Worship Center. Thank you.
losing a parent is one of the most difficult situations we must face. And this is something that I am familiar with because this year will make 37 years since I would have lost my mother. The pain of grief can be so overwhelming that anything someone says, of course, can be heightened by emotion. Today, the Ministry of Public Infrastructure, Posts and Urban Development joins with the many who have come to show our support to a dear friend and colleague. For us, the loss of a colleague's loved one is a loss for all of us. Her beloved son, Leroy Yaga Francis, is a water overseer at the Water Services Department, and I would dare say a dedicated employee. I believe that the strong work ethic and the pleasant personality that Leroy possesses are attributed largely to his upbringing, to the kind of mother he had. Mr. Francis, please accept our condolences on the loss of your mother. Our thoughts and prayers are with you and your family during this trying time. Your mother demonstrated a love for Christ and served him faithfully. Find comfort knowing that she is with her Maker and her Redeemer. I also wish to bring greetings from your minister, Minister Richards, Deputy Prime Minister, who sends his sympathy and best wishes to you and your family at this very difficult time. May the soul of your beloved mother rest in eternal peace. Today, the ministry will pay tribute in song. What a day that will be.
Come and
Touch Money's Women and Dance Ministries. Blessed, good afternoon again. We just want to share with the family of Minister Elizabeth Francis this afternoon. In our tribute to her, she was a mother of our ministry, and on behalf of Apostle, our prophetess, Bernard and Michelle Huggins, the members and leaders of the church family, we just want to bring comfort to the family in this time of their bereavement. May you be blessed. Goodbye, world. She stays no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. She stays no longer with you. She's made up her mind to go God's way.
If you're the kind who takes the time to to help a stranger in the rain. There's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees, Elizabeth Francis.
we now have Holy City Worship Center.
Thank you.
now welcome Kayano Francis for the New Testament lesson taken from 1 Corinthians 50, verse 50 to 58.
The scripture reading is taken from 1 Corinthians 50 to 58. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither that corruption inherit corruption. Behold, I show you a mystery, that we shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that it is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the word of the Lord, for as much as ye know that our labor is not in vain in the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
We now have a special tribute by Bernicia Francis Richardson, the daughter.
She never meet you and never tell you about Christ. And I thank God for her. But what our mission on earth is to tell. The Bible commands us that we must go and tell. So this afternoon, I just want to make my mom proud, even in her grave, because she knows I'm not a front person. But she will say, Catherine, go and do it. You sit too long in church and doing nothing. And it's not easy to stand. I don't like her. She knows that also. But anything for my mom, God is good. We live a life pleasing unto her and unto God. Because we don't want when any news come back to her, she feel angry, because that's not the way she has brought us up. And I just thank God that he has lent us one of his gems, and he is able to take her back home in glory. Knowing God is the best thing. And as mom would say, trust God, give him your life, and let him take control. Give him your life, and it's just not give him your life, but have a relationship with God. It's worth it all. God give you the peace when you go through times like these. Trust him. He never will leave you nor forsake you. He will always be with you. Church, if I said nothing and you don't remember, serve God is the best thing you could ever do. Trust him. He is the God of impossible. He is the God that brings peace in the storm. He is the God that brings peace in the wind. He is the God that takes you over the Red Sea and you wonder why. What a mighty God we serve. Thank you.
The congregation to stand with us as we sing the hymn, Will Your Anchor Hold?
When your anchor holds in the storm of life, when
invite the Right Honorable Dr. Denzel Douglas to give his tribute.
Sorrow and the biting agony as we of the communities of the Capistrian region and of course the members of the His Wounded Hands we join with these family members, all of us, to say our final goodbye to a dearly beloved Christian lady from St. Paul's Village. I would want to refer to her as Associate Pastor Elizabeth Francis. Who cultivated a saving vision of gender equality here in our country. Beth, as she was affectionately called, had a sense of humor, a spirit of caring for the least of these, a sharp and determined mind, and a capacity for empathy. To my mind, what makes her life, or made her life outstanding, is not just what she has done for the Lord, but what God has accomplished through her own holy obedience. I say that because I recall her visit to the office of the Prime Minister, which I occupied at that time with Apostle Pastor Huggins. Speaking on behalf of her congregation, and seeking the support of my office to obtain land to build a church that has now been built. She was a voice crying in the wilderness, a voice with boundless hope, immeasurable love, and righteous courage to say exactly what God wanted her to share with me on that day. Although, of course, Elizabeth Bedbeth would have come from humble beginnings right here in our village and of an ordinary background, Pastor Elizabeth Francis channeled her energies into works of value, into bouts of helping and bouts of leaping faith, and pockets of deep pioneering. She became a powerful woman of God and associate pastor engaged in the founding of a faith-loving, community sharing, church family touched by his wounded hands, Ministries International. In fact, it was just a few months ago, with spirited joy, that I attended the opening of this same church building in the St. Peter's Shadwell area. It was a marvelous lifetime achievement that expressed gladness, quiet beauty, and praiseworthy worship. I think, therefore, Catherine, her daughter, expressed that only a moment ago. I was truly honored to share in this experience of memory and meditation, especially when I was engaged in the act of presenting her one of the important poems that showed how the church was recognizing her for what she would have achieved on this earth so far. I want to emphasize that Beth, her role as a mother of all adult children, each in his own right and her in their own right, serving in the capacity that God would have led them to serve, in public and private service, helping mankind in so many different ways. She was a servant of the common people, a pillar of women's leadership in the community and in the church, and these would be forever affirmed and emulated and perpetuated, I'm sure, by those who are left to mourn and remember her. She lived a life pleasing to God and was always driven to follow the directives of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. That is why this afternoon I want to submit that she has lived a full, purpose-driven life. If it is one thing I am certain that she would have fulfilled on this earth for the time that God lent her to us, is that she has been a co-founder of a church, of a faith, that will forever live on to win souls to his glory. And so she has not wasted her life. May her soul rest in the grave, and may she rise to hear sounds of the trumpet when the saints of God go marching on eventually. And so let us leave here today, knowing that we will see Pastor again. We will see Beth again if we remain devoted to the resurrection and the life. Jesus' comforting presence will take us into moments of holy communion until we sense heaven's glory and accept that God's mercy over us is eternal love. May her soul rest in peace and rise again in glory. God bless you. Thank you.
We now have a formal remembrance by Charlie's Francis, the granddaughter. Thank you.
Gwenneth Francis, better known as Bet-Bet, born in the island of St. Kitts on July 27, 1952 to Jeremiah and Nelly Francis, both deceased. She was raised by her parents in the village of St. Paul. She loved her country life. She was never fond of going to Bastia for work. Her first experience working in Bastia as a domestic worker, her tasks included washing, cleaning, and the worst of them all, ironing. Grandma mustered the strength to get through the work day. When she returned home, she told her mother while in tears, "I am not going back," just because she hated ironing. Grandma was employed at the Belmont estate for many years. She worked on the estate until the closure of the sugar industry. She was a hard worker, very committed to her task, as she provided for her five children, Catherine Chai, Julian Rewai, and Rubia, who is now deceased. She instilled in them to be independent people in society. When her sister Carmen Francis died in 1980, she was left with the added responsibility of raising Carmen's five children, named Caroline, Ken, Tessa, Lillian, who suddenly passed away on Tuesday of this week. And last of them all was Nigel, who was about 2 years old. I heard stories of grandma cooking as if she was running a restaurant, with up to 15 plates or bowls on the serving table daily. She always said to Catherine, "Sometimes you're up, sometimes you're down, sometimes you're neither up nor down." Those were some very strong words to meditate on. She taught her children to trust and serve God. Grandma said to Aunt Catherine, "I am 45 years, and I am turning everything to God." We watched Grandma over the years holding on to the hand of God, never once let go. Grandma was ordained the mother of the ministry in March 2012 at Touch by His Wounded Hands Ministry International. She was a mighty woman of God, committed and dedicated to the work of God. The word of God says, "The fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth souls is wise." This was demonstrated by Grandma every Monday. Every Monday, Grandma went to Dr. William Connor Primary School to conduct morning assembly with the staff and students of that school. She sang and encouraged them with prayer. On Friday afternoons, she did hospital ministry, where she prayed and targeted at least one soul on every occasion. Miss Ivy Challenger accompanied her. She was always pleased upon her return, while she reported mission accomplished. One Friday, Grandma could not find her father's teeth. She looked up and down and was very unsuccessful. Grandma left to go to the hospital without them, and on her way, she said, "Hey, take that devil." Upon her return, she found them on the doorstep. Grandma arrived very early in the morning for prayer with Miss John and Sister Janice before they left for work. Then she will pray with apostle and prophetess, asking God to come in. Grandma prayed for all her children and the whole neighborhood, calling them by name. She took pleasure in conducting fundraisers for the ministry. Sponsorship, johnny cakes, and fried fish, her favorite. Selling to the neighborhood to assist the church in buying its first book. Grandma never gave back change. She would always say, "That is for the church." Grandma had fought a good fight and finished her race. She did not leave behind any unfinished task. She touched lives and made a great impact. Her favorite departing words whenever you visit her was, "God go with you." But today we can say, "Grandma, God is with you." We will always hold her dear to our hearts. Rest in peace.
Now we'll have a tribute by the Antioch Baptist Church, and then a special selection from Brother Cleon Lewis will follow.
Good afternoon, church. A resolution in loving memory of Elizabeth Gwenneth Bedford Francis. We, the members of the United Baptist Church, pay our respects to our sister in faith, Elizabeth Gwenneth Francis. Whereas Elizabeth was an integral part in the body of Christ and her local church community. Whereas Elizabeth was a tireless leader in her local church, touched by his wounded hands ministries. Whereas Elizabeth served her community outside the church by working in the agricultural sector as a leader and enterprising woman. Whereas Elizabeth committed to creating more beauty in the world through her culinary skills. Whereas Elizabeth was kind, compassionate, and a loving human being. Be it resolved that the United Baptist Church offers its sincere condolences to the family of Elizabeth Francis, especially Deacon Julian Francis and his wife, Minister Marita Francis. And in this, we share a poem, Gone From My Sight, by Henry Van Dyke. I am standing upon the seashore. A ship at my side spreads her white sails to the moving breeze and starts for the blue ocean. She's an object of beauty and strength. I stand and watch her until, at length, she hangs like a speck of white cloud just where the sea and the sky come to mingle with each other. Then someone at my side says, there she is gone. But gone where? Gone from my sight. That is all. She's just as large in mast, hull, and spare as she was when she left my side. And she's just as able to bear her load of living freight to her destined port. Her diminished size is in me, not in her. And just at the moment when someone says, there she's gone, there are others whose eyes are watching her coming. And voices ready to take up the glad shout. Here she comes. Here she comes. And that is dying. Troubles and trials often betray us, causing the weary body to strain. But we shall walk.
Good afternoon, church. Today I give God praise. Today I give Him thanks for the life of Elizabeth Francis. God sees, God knows, God understands. Who can compare to God? At the mention of His name, He said, every knee shall bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You may be dead physically, but you are present with the Lord. And I know she is in the arm of the Lord God, our Maker. I know Sister Beckbed for many years. And one thing I could say about her, as I said last night, she's a very bold woman. She's not a coward. If you're looking somebody to be a soldier, she would be the person to do that part. She might not fight physically, but her mouth, she can fight with her mouth. I showed you the enemy would run, said the woman too much first. As a young boy coming up, as I said, what song? I was asked to do a song today. I said, what song can I sing? And there's a song I always sang. That song has been my anthem for many years. See? And I'll show you now this song. It goes like this. In the dark of the midnight, have I walked and hid my face, while the storm holds above me, and there's no hiding place. Mid the crash of the thunder, precious Lord, hear my cry. Keep me safe till the storm passes by. You can sing the chorus with me. Till the storm. Till the storm passes over. Till the thunder sounds no more. Till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Passes by, hallelujah, glory be to God. Many times Satan whispers, there is no need to try, for there is no end of sorrows, there's no hope. Oh, glory be to God. But I know God, oh my God, and tomorrow I rise where the clouds never darken the sky. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more. Till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand, Lord, in the hollow of thy hands. Keep me safe till the storm passes by. Glory to God. Let me stand in thy presence on that bright, oh, glory be to God. In
land where the tempters never come. May I dwell with thee till the storm passes by. Come on, lift your voice and sing. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Oh, hold me fast, let me stand on in the hollow of thy hand. Keep me safe till the storm passes by. The anchor holds. Though a ship may be battered, the anchor.
This is my part.
I have fallen on my knees when I face the raging seas, the anchor holds. In spite,
glory be to God, of the storm. One thing Mother Elizabeth tell me, that at her funeral she don't want no dead thing. That's one thing she always tell me. She want no crying, she want no weeping, she want no mourning. She just want a time of enjoyment. She want a time of celebration. So I just want, permit me to do this last song. Put a beat. But the curves of each of the glory be to God. Mother Elizabeth, this one is for you.
I look in the hymn and I wondered and I saw a song that has been sung at the graveside. It said, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Glory be to God. And I just want to do that song today. For Mother is Elizabeth Francis. Glory be to God.
This is a time of celebration. Trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time will be no more. And the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the savior of the earth shall come on the other shore, and the rolling skull up yonder, I'll be there. When the rolling skull up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On that bright and glorious morning, when the dead in Christ arise, and the glorious resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the rolling skull up yonder, I'll be there. When the rolling skull up yonder, when the rolling skull up yonder, when the call up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. Let us labor for the master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us suffer for this wondrous love and care. Then when all life is over, on our work on earth is done, and the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the road is called up yonder, when the road
the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. Death's not a friend like a lonely Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. No friend like him. He does so diseases. No, not one. No, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lonely Jesus. No, not one. No, not one.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah. Come on, there's not a friend like a lonely Jesus. No, not one. Amen. We have come to share a word of the Lord to this congregation. I'm not preaching to the dead. I've done enough to her. As I was sitting there, now I understand why the Lord said to me to use the church colors and make a flag. Because one of the things that Sister Elizabeth always said to me, nothing is going to move me out of touch by His Wounded Hands ministry than six bearers. We are not in the building today. That's why the Lord laid it on my heart to use the flag. Because when the six bearers take her out and take her to the place, yes, we know that she have done her task. Also, just want to make a correction with what the Right Honorable Dr. Denzel Douglas, leader of the opposition. In March this year, the church celebrated our 10th anniversary, and we honor our leaders, especially Mother Elizabeth and Ivory Challenger. I thank God for them. And it is so true that when I was seeking a piece of land, Mother Elizabeth walked with me every step of the way to then Prime Minister Douglas' office. She worked with me. But every time she leave that office, she always tell him, remember, God love you. Remember that you need to accept Him before it is too late. And truly, I thank God for this mighty woman of God. She is our hero, as I said. And I'd like to share a word with you this afternoon. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, reading from verse 13 down, but I like to look at verse 16 and 17, where the Bible said that they shall be a shout, and let me back up a little bit. He said that, what Paul said, I don't want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who've gone to sleep. But Paul was encouraging the saints at the time that when one died knowing Christ as the Savior, that there is hope. Telling what Paul is saying to the church, that if we keep trusting God, that someday we will see Mother Elizabeth again. I stopped by to tell somebody this afternoon that the trumpet will sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, and only those that are remained that know Jesus Christ as the Savior shall be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air. My question to you this afternoon, are you ready
will come. That's why the Bible says that we all must be ready. For the time will come when you and I have to depart this life, and only what born for Christ will last. The time is coming when God Himself shall descend with a shout from heaven. Oh my God, I don't know about you, but I'm looking forward for that shout when the sky bursts open and there is a shout. If I'm alive, I'll be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. What about you this afternoon? We have so many plans. Look at how from 2019 the world has changed. Oh my God, but understand, things will get worse because Jesus is about to put in His appearance. Are you ready to meet your Master? We heard of all the kind words of Elizabeth Francis. I stopped by to tell you this afternoon that when Jesus put in His appearance, He's not coming getting a book from the church. He's coming with His own record. And it's only what done for Christ with us. Are you ready to meet your Maker? Whether we like it, yes or not, we all have an appointment with Almighty God. The thing about it, we can change appointments with doctors. We can change appointment with government. But this appointment in the book of Hebrews, chapter 9 and verse 27, he said, we all have an appointment. I remember talking to mom, and she always said to me, Apostle, I'm not afraid to die. My mind made up. I'm ready to go when the Lord ready for me. Many times I see her go low. I felt it was over. But mom will bounce back and said, the devil lose. God ain't ready for me yet. But the time will come. I remember the Friday afternoon when I went to visit her at the hospital. Oh my God, I know that when I leave the hospital, that was the last time I will see her alive. But understand, I know that she had a relationship with God and her mind was made up to go home with her Master. Because her labor was finished. What about you and I this afternoon? Yes, many of us we sing, we want to see her someday, but understand, she make it right with her God. And if you are going to see her, you must make it right with God before it is too late. Amen. He's coming back with a shout. I said, he's coming back with a shout. I remember 2 weeks before mom passed, I remember the Lord said to me, I want when you're doing the service, got a service of thanksgiving. And we had that last night. But your shout, because I know if mom was here in physical, you should have been shouting, saying thank you, Jesus. Praise be to God, for God is better to me than to, and I am to myself. For the woman who had praise, she know what it is to praise God in the good time. She know what it is to praise God when things are not so good. She know what it is to praise God when things are real bad. Ah, my God, all because she had a relationship with God. That when death, I believe, that mom and God had a conversation, and I believe that God said to her, don't bother go back. Like Enoch, don't bother go back. You come too far. It's better over here. And I believe that mom said, I am ready to stay with you. Are you ready to stay with God this afternoon? For the time will come. Yes, people looking for carnival and all kinds of things to jump. But understand that can't help you. The only thing can help us in this difficult time is Jesus Christ. Oh God, and can I say that? I don't want to take it out of context, but please hear me. I'm listening to all, and our former prime minister is a doctor, and I respect doctors, but understand this crisis that the world is facing today. Not easy that scientists knows exactly how to handle it, but understand, I know there is a man by the name of Jesus Christ. He's able to handle any kind of sickness. I'm a caller. We gone from a country whereby we are saying we are depending on God, and now we are saying, excuse me, we are depending on a vaccination to save our life. But hear me, the blood of Jesus never lose his power. The blood of Jesus is the remedy. My God, I remember hearing one singing, the blood of Jesus is my remedy. Is the blood of Jesus still our remedy today? The blood of Jesus, when you're washed in the blood, I said when you're washed in the blood, only God alone can protect you. It doesn't matter what we face, when you're covered under the blood, when you're under the blood, you know that you're safe under the blood. That's what's going to take us. For when the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, and we which are remain, come on, it's gonna take the blood of Jesus to keep us under that blood. In spite of all what's going on around us, when I speak to Mother Elizabeth, she always said, God is in control. Nothing happened before it time. I stopped by to tell somebody, this is a great opportunity for you to give your life to Jesus Christ before it is too late. A judgment day is coming. You and I will stand before the judgment seat of Christ, and only what done for him will last. Excuse me, that's all I know. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. 1995, Elizabeth Francis turned her life over to God, and from since then until her death, she said, what can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. She said, I'm under the rock, and the rock is higher than I. I'm telling somebody this afternoon that you better run under the rock before it is too late. That rock is Jesus Christ. Hear me in closing. The trumpet will sound. Someday, the trumpet will sound. Are you ready to meet your Maker? Let me ask a question again. The trumpet will sound. Whether we like it, yes or not. Whether you're saved, yes or not. The trumpet will sound. Are you ready to meet your God? If you're not ready to meet your God, What a great opportunity. Elizabeth Francis, she was a soul winner. She'll go to the hospital Friday after Friday, along with Ivy Challenger. She will tell people about the goodness of God. And I remember one day she said, she asked God a question. God, if something like this will happen to me, what must I do? And she said, God answered her and said, the same way you encourage people, you encourage yourself. It is difficult to encourage yourself when you are in a situation.
You can encourage her. I can tell the Francis family, don't cry. But I'm not in the shoes. Oh no. I can tell St. Paul's people, don't cry, but I'm not in your shoes. It's when you are in it, when you know the pain and the suffering that somebody is going through.
This afternoon, this family is leading their mother, their auntie, their grandmother, and a few more weeks or days, they will lay another family member to rest. Come on, don't tell me that's not something easy to go through. Before one go down, here come the message of another one. You better know that God is in control. No more. And used to say that God is in control. God give and God take it away. The trumpet will sound. Are you ready when the trumpet sound?
For that day, it doesn't matter where you run. If you run to the sea will say, I need help. If you run to the mountain will say, I can't hide you.
Where can you run from the presence of God? This is an opportunity. But if you don't know Christ, could you stand with me, prophetess? Can she come? Is she able? Can you stand with me? Let us all stand. Let us all stand. I don't know. And of God, could you just get us just a song, one verse of a song? She was always in the soul winning. I don't know what it is, yes. I'm going to give my wife a chance to do this.
I'll put you in front of my melody.
You have just heard the word of God. Every Friday, I'm on target at least one soul. We always pray. Before she got to the hospital, she said, even one soul. And I'm standing here this afternoon, appealing to somebody to surrender their life unto Almighty God. We were touched by mom. We were impacted. And it had to be something. Even on our leave, when we are leaving, she said, God go with you. Today, she is with the Lord. How is your soul? What are you? Are you ready with the trump sound? Without a shadow of a doubt that you're going to be going with your maker? Or would you have to wonder if we listen to the death announcement, the young, the old, but these days are the very young. Death come. We cannot get accustomed to death. I experienced it during the course of this week. We had heard, yes, a family member just passed, and I was listening to her voice on the telephone when her life just slipped away. You can die in your sleep. This pandemic, so many people are depending on the vaccine. But we are depending on Psalms 91. We say, he that dwelleth upon whoever he kills. Mom was the sole winner. She had done her part. She had gone on, and she did not leave behind an unfinished task. I'm appealing for one soul, just even one, that the Holy Ghost will convict you. I surrendered my life to God at the funeral service where three young boys died that were at the ages of 17, 18, and 21. And I left my seat because I wanted to make sure that my soul was right, that when God called me, I am ready. Is there one this afternoon? Is there one this afternoon? Who knows, this might be the last sermon that you might hear.
His way. We now commit the remain of Elizabeth Francis to the ground, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. When we all get to heaven, that's the first song we're going to sing. Those who are in charge of us at the graveside.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sign. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus,
where a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard an old, old story, how a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his wounded, of his blessed blood atoned. life work is ended and I cross the swelling tide. When the bright and glorious morning I shall see, I shall know my Redeemer when I reach the other side and he smiles. Please be reminded that we are at a service. We ask you to respect. We ask you to keep your voices down. Please, we are having a service. Thank you. When my life work is ended and I cross the swelling tide,
I'm
Amen. Some glad morning when this light is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. Savior God, to thee. I see the stars. Amen. The psalmist declares in Psalm 121, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in, from this time forth, even forevermore. Amen. The Lord is my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me down to lie. In pastures green, he leadeth me. The quiet waters by. The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want.
The way we're gonna lay the week, the family will be first, followed by the Honorable Dr. Denzel Douglas, leader of the opposition, and then the church, then anybody else. So family come first, please. Children, let me say children, the children come first. Hold on a while. rest of the children. Then we'll have the leader of the opposition. Church.